Hi, I'm Mary Pua, the chemistry guru, and you are watching H2ChemX, making H2 chemistry simpler, one video at a time. Hi everyone, now in this video we'll go through the reactions of halogenyl alkenes. Now altogether we have three preparation reactions and four reactions of halogenyl alkenes. So let's take a look at the reactions as well as the reagents and conditions. Now the first preparation reaction is a free radical substitution of our alkenes to halogenyl alkene. I'm substituting this hydrogen with our halogen. So what's the reagents and conditions for this conversion? Our halogen in the presence of UV light. So this conversion is done via halogen, either chlorine or bromine, in the presence of UV light. Now the second preparation reaction involves electrophilic addition of our alkene to our halogenyl alkene. What's the reagents and conditions for this conversion? HX gas at room temperature. So this addition reaction of our HX is done via HX gaseous state at room temperature. Now the third preparation reaction involves our nucleophilic substitution of our OH functional group to our halogen. So what's the reagents and conditions for this conversion? Now it depends on the halogen that we are substituting. If I'm substituting chlorine, then we use PCl5 or SOCl2 anhydrous at room temperature. Now if I'm substituting bromine, then the reagents and conditions will be HBr or PBr3 warm. So therefore the reagents and conditions depends on the halogen that we are substituting. If you're substituting chlorine, then we use PCl5 SOCl2 anhydrous at room temperature. If I'm substituting bromine, then we use HBr or PBr3 warm. Now let us move on to the reactions of halogenyl alkenes. The four reactions. The first one involves the elimination of our HX to give us our alkene. So what's the reagents and conditions for this conversion? KOH in ethanol reflux. So this elimination reaction to give us our alkene is done via KOH in ethanol reflux. Now the second reaction of halogenyl alkene involves the nucleophilic substitution of our halogen to our OH functional group. So what's the reagents and conditions for this conversion? NaOH aqueous reflux. So this nucleophilic substitution is done via NaOH aqueous reflux. Now the third reaction is again a nucleophilic substitution, but this time I'm converting our halogen to NH2 functional group. So this is my amine functional group. So what is the reagents and conditions for this conversion? Excess ammonia in ethanol, heat in situ. So this nucleophilic substitution to convert our halogenyl alkene to amine is done via excess ammonia in ethanol, heat in situ. Now reaction number 4, we have the nucleophilic substitution of our halogen to a nitrile functional group. So what's the reagents and conditions for this conversion? NaCN in ethanol reflux. So this reaction to convert our halogen to nitrile is done via NaCN in ethanol reflux. Okay, we have gone through all the reactions of halogenyl alkene. Now remember, we have 3 preparation reactions and 4 reactions. Hopefully by watching this video, it helps you remember all these reagents and conditions more easily. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please give me the thumbs up, like this video, and share this with your friends. For more awesome JCH2 chemistry video lessons, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have any feedback, questions, and suggestions to new video lessons, please drop them at the comment section. I'm also conducting JCH2 chemistry classes at Bishan Central. Please visit my website for more information. Thank you for watching H2ChemX. I'll see you next time.